All right. Hey, folks. My name is Mike Negley. I'm here with the lovely Nora Ankrom. We are here at the premiere of Hay Fever, the movie, brought to you by Alchemy Theatre Troupe, Dutch Miller, a whole bunch of other sponsors. We've got everyone in the world here tonight, it seems. But we're going to start off by talking to Nora Ankrom. She is the executive producer for Alchemy Theatre and about the busiest woman in show business. Nora, could you tell us a little bit about what you do for Alchemy?
Sure. Well, I'm executive director, like you said, and I kind of keep things moving for the whole season, for the whole picture, the big picture, I guess, is what my job is, making all the moving pieces work together.
Fantastic. All right. I imagine that's quite a job. So can you tell us a little bit about how Hay Fever the movie came to be?
Yeah. So in the midst of COVID, we weren't sure what we were going to be able to do with live theater. And we set a deadline of February 1st to decide, can we do this with a live audience or do we need to make it like a movie? And obviously we decided to make it a movie. And from there, we rehearsed it like a play and then filmed it like a movie. And I'm really, really excited to see how it turned out.
Fantastic. Well, I know filming during the pandemic is not really a super easy task. From where I am as a board member, I know we took a bunch of precautions for all of the people filming. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, we rehearsed in masks the whole 6 weeks, and then we cohorted, and we were all vaccinated by the time we spent, 14 to 16 hours in the same house together. but yeah, we were all very... very kept together and very safe about all of it.
Yeah, yeah. That's very important. So I do understand that Alchemy got a major grant from the West Virginia Humanities Council. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so our the major grant that we received from the West Virginia Humanities Council is for our next event, the West Virginia Shakespeare Festival, which is coming to you in June at Barbersville Park Amphitheater, and we're able to expand the festival quite a bit this year because of the grant. So stay tuned for that. Visit our website for more details.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Nora. I'm sure we will catch up to you in just a few. All right. I believe that we have somebody up next to talk to. I'm going to hand the mic over to my buddy John Campbell.
Here we are with Mayor of Huntington, well, with First Lady of Huntington, and who's also plays the mother in this Judith Bliss in the Hay Fever. Mary, we're glad to have you here. Mayor, welcome as well. We're delighted to have you both. We were talking before coming on about Mary has an extensive background in theater. Tell us a little bit about what you've done before this show.
Well, I started in high school and college, nice. And I've got back into it after a 20-year break.
Wow.
By going
yep.
back to Marshall. I
yep.
got my degree and have done some things at Marshall and have done some repertory theater, and really fortunate to have gotten involved again in Alchemy Theater.
And it's been our win. Yeah.
Plays up in New York and outside of Syracuse.
In the Finger Lake District at Cortland Repertory Theater, I was fortunate enough to go back several years in a row and did a lot of murder mystery, and my favorite show was 6 Dance Lessons in 6 Weeks, comedy.
It's a widow of a retired Baptist preacher.
Oh,
you would really enjoy that.
Yeah. Well, all right. That's terrific. Mary, Steve, thank you very much. Delighted you're here. Can hardly wait to see you on the screen. You look fabulous.
Oh, thank you.
Don't you? You see this? Looks fabulous. Back over to you, Mike.
All right. Once again, I'm Mike Negley with Alchemy Theatre. If you're just joining us, we are here at the Hay Fever live premiere of Hay Fever the movie with Alchemy Theatre Troupe. This is Bill Neal. He's kind of a big deal.
Oh, stop.
He's joining us once again, an old friend of ours.
That's it.
Bill, could you tell us a little bit about your character in Hay Fever?
My character is the lead in Hay Fever. It's the center figure. It's the dad who every everyone else runs around and embraces and... No. I have like a cameo. I'll be on screen all of 6 frames tonight. Don't blink, you'll miss me.
That's kind of it.
I'm sure. Well, Bill, so you've done a ton of theater.
A ton.
Quite a bit. Now, how much film have you done in the area?
Okay. There is a, somewhere in the world, there is a 60-second, I want to say it was Venco Bank commercial, and that's it.
Alright,
that's it.
So this was sort of a new experience.
This was completely a new experience.
So I would have only done it because people I loved were involved. That's it. I'm a sucker. I can't say no. When someone I love says, hey, would you like to? Yes, of course. Why not?
Which is exactly why we got you involved, because we knew we could sucker you into it.
Exactly.
So can you tell me?
The old guy you knew who was like, yeah, I could do that.
Can you tell me a little bit about the difference between your time on stage and filming?
We're about to see that. What I'm anxious about, and everyone else is joyful and jolly and wonderful, and there's some beautiful people in this movie. I'm mostly concerned about seeing this face 40 feet wide. It makes me hyperventilate. So, yeah, that's a thing.
Well, fantastic.
I'm worried.
Thank you so much,
Thank
Bill.
You. How
I
kind
appreciate
of you.
It. We'll see you on screen in just a few.
Crazy about you.
All right. Well, we've got the Kinleys watching. They say hi. James Holly says it's all about Bill, and he is definitely right. Lindsay Daniels watching. Mark Cooper says, how exciting. Thank you, Mark. We are very proud of everyone involved in the production as well. I'm going to hand the mic over to John Campbell, my buddy here.
We have 2 members of the cast. Here I am flanked by such beauty. I feel like an onion in a petunia patch. Here to my right and your left, we have Joanna Murdock.
Hello.
Who plays Myra Arundel, yes. one of the guests, am
one
I
the
right?
Guests, yes.
One of the guests, yes. Who shows up and causes utter chaos.
Yes, I do.
And on the other side, we have Sheila Meade, who plays the maid Clara. Perhaps the only sane person in him, is that fair enough?
Yes, the only sane person in the house.
The only sane person. Okay, what's it like being at a premiere of a movie you're in?
It's absolutely a first, for sure. Absolutely, yeah, you know.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
It's a first.
It's a first? Okay. Are you nervous?
A little.
A little?
A little.
A little?
Yes.
How does your nerves for this compare to a stage play opening night nerves?
Well, with the stage play, I have to perform that night. This, I've already done it, so I just have to sit back and let it happen.
So you get to sit back and enjoy it.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, look at this. Look at these 2 young, lovely ladies dolled up. Look at these dresses, okay? All right.
Here's
the question. Yeah, who are you wearing?
Amazon.com.
Okay, all right. Who are you wearing?
I think it was Belk, maybe.
Oh, all right. So here we are. I mean, that's the question they ask, right?
That's
who are you wearing?
Who are you wearing?
Okay, who are you wearing? Lindsay
Daniels
is watching.
Lindsay.
Wait, say hello.
Lindsay Daniels, if you're watching, I thought I heard your name. Hello, it's good to see you.
Well, all right, Lindsay. Hope you're there. That's terrific. Thank you, ladies. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Here you are, Michael Nagley. Back over to you.
All right. Thank you, John. All right. Next up, we've got a sponsor for the show. This is Joe Stowers. He's with Hometown Lenders. He is one of our sponsors, and I said, Joe, can you tell us a little bit about about what your company does?
Yes, we do residential mortgage lending in Ohio, West Virginia, and Kentucky.
That's quite a spread. That's fantastic. Do you have a website where people can learn more about the business or anything like that?
Oh, yes, just hometownlenders.com, and we're located right in Barbersville on Route 60.
Fantastic. So what led you to get involved in all of this?
Well, I really think that this is just an amazing outreach for the community, and whenever they asked me to be a sponsor, I was tickled. Yeah, I mean, obviously there's a lot of people here that have a lot of talents, and they just needed an outlet to be able to get it out, and I couldn't believe they're making a movie right here, and this is just wonderful. I'm just happy to be a part of it.
Right. Well, it's going to be a doozy, I'm sure. We've got a huge amount of talent involved in this production.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Joe. Really appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you guys for doing this.
Absolutely. It's good to see you. All right. I'm going to hand the mic back over to John Campbell.
All right. Here, come in here. We have Brian Cook, Brian plays the brother in Sorel, and introduce us your plus one.
My plus one. This is Caitlin Hall from Louisa.
From Louisa. All right, Caitlin, we're delighted you're here. What's it like, Caitlin, to be with a movie star on an opening night of a movie?
Well, it's pretty special. I mean, I got to wear this dress for it, so.
Well, that's right. And who are you wearing?
I'm just going to call it myself.
Okay. There you go. All right. Caitlin is wearing Caitlin. Brian, tell us about this movie business.
Oh, you're going to love it. It's a great business. I'm going to start in this business. I'm going to keep going in this business. And I'm never going to stop in this business.
And you saw it first here, right? It's just your first movie role?
It's my first movie role of all time.
Now, we shared the stage a couple of years ago now, isn't
That's
it?
Right,
in 12th Night. In Shakespeare's 12th Night, we were drunk the whole night together.
The whole 12th Night, we were drunk.
But we had great fun with it. So I know what kind of talent we have here. I can hardly wait to see your work.
Yeah, I know. I can't wait to see it either.
So the cast has not seen this yet, huh?
No, not that I know of.
Nobody's seen it.
Okay, what was it like shooting? You shot it in 3 days.
Yeah, they were three really long days, I'll tell you that. They're really long. I mean, after it was over, it was just so awesome. I remember feeling so good the next day. But during the actual filming, I mean, it could get hot in there. The hours could run long. But overall, man, I'm so glad I did it. It's awesome. I cannot wait for this.
Okay, now as opposed to a stage play, if you were doing this live, and Alchemy had thought about, planned maybe to do Hay Fever live, you know, as a straight play, but the pandemic didn't allow that, and so we pivoted to doing a movie with it.
Yes.
So in doing the movie, if you're doing the stage play, you get one shot at it, right?
One shot, and you have better...
Better nail
everything.
It. Yeah,
nail
right.
It.
Okay, but with the movie,
you get a couple of shots.
Yeah. I mean, I hear about scenes that, you know, 200 takes to do.
Oh, yeah.
You didn't have that kind of
this
time.
This is not a Kubrick film, no. This is a Vance production.
Yeah, all right. So, get it the first time.
That's right. One take Brian is what they called me.
Well, thank you very much. Enjoy it. Have a blast. Thank you for your time. Mr. Nagley, here you go.
Oh, thank you very much. All right, this is Mike. I'm back, and I was going to get a hold of Mr. Stephen Vance, but he is already being interviewed. He's on Instagram Live right now. So, Todd, let's grab over Miss Jessie Jasko. This is Jessie. She's our student intern for Hay Fever. Jessie, can you tell us a little bit about how you got involved in this craziness?
Well, Stephen actually called me about 3 weeks before they started rehearsals. He was like, hey, we need a student intern, and we want you to do it. And I was, of course, super flattered, super exciting. And through the process, I just got to work with them, learn about production, directing, and also learn from these incredible actors and actresses, and learn a little bit about film, which I've never done before. So it's been a crazy, amazing process.
That's awesome. And you do have a theater background with First Stage, I think?
I do, yes. I've done some First Stage and some Heart production.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic. So what was the big differences between film and stage? What hit you as just the craziest stuff?
Well, of course, the craziest thing to me was, like, you get to redo it if you mess up, which is crazy because, you know, on stage, you just got to go with it. That was a big difference. It was also just the coolest thing to sit behind a monitor and see the two different camera angles and having to reset every scene because you have to focus on this person for this scene and this person for this scene. Needless to say, I will never watch a movie the same again, understanding how much work goes into it.
I am sure. Well, thank you very much, Jesse. It was a pleasure having you involved in all of this. Enjoy the film.
Next up on Facebook Live is the director of this whole thing. You're going to have to step back to get all of them in it.
Hello, Facebook Live.
Stephen Vance.
Hello, Facebook Live. Good to see you. Thank you for tuning in, and make sure you come see the show. We've got two more chances to see the show. I'm really excited. I mean, if you can't tell, this is pretty fun out here tonight. There's a lot going on, and we're sad that you're not here. You couldn't actually get in, but we're sad that you're not here.
But you have two more chances to see Hay Fever, the movie, Friday, May 21st at 8 p.m. in Ritter Park. And then it'll be showing at the Heritage Station on Wednesday, May 26th, also at 8 p.m. You can find out, you can get those dates. If that just went past you, go to HayFeverTheMovie.com.
HeyFeverTheMovie.com. HeyFeverTheMovie.com. It's a pretty cool website. You can watch the trailer, production photos, get all kinds of information. I've got to go shake some hands. Thank you for having me on the show, John. And I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Delighted. Can't wait to see his work. At HeyFeverTheMovie.com, you can get cast bios. You get, as well as you mentioned, the trailers. It has a place to get tickets to the Ritter Park viewing of the movie Friday week, on Friday the 21st. I guess that's this next Friday, isn't it? Or and information about the Heritage Station as well. Michael, back to you.
All right, this is Caden Tooley, correct?
Yes.
And he is with Regeneration Church and also was first assistant camera, is that correct? Fantastic. So, Caden, can you tell us a little bit about your film background?
Yeah, so I've been making films in the Huntington area for probably 6 years now. I went to Marshall, so I'm an alumni. So I fill roles in crews, all kinds of roles, but primarily find myself shooting films. So.
Awesome. Well, how did you get involved in this project?
I was asked. I kind of inquired about it because I worked with Mike Murdock on The Good Fight. He was assistant director.
Right, okay.
And I shot that film, so we worked closely. And he told me about this project, and I was like, I'd love to get involved and help Todd in any way. So Todd and Mike pulled me on as assistant camera. So.
That's fantastic. All right. Well, we mentioned Regeneration Church. Regeneration Church, you're on 4th Avenue and 14th Street, is that right? Above the old lattice.
Yes.
Regeneration has been very good to Alchemy. We've been rehearsing there quite a few of our shows over the last year, and you guys have been just fantastic. Can you tell me a little bit about Regeneration Church and, you know, where people can learn more about that?
Yeah, for sure. Well, my dad's the pastor, Tracy Tooley, and we meet, like you said, on 4th Avenue, just a block from campus, and you can find anything you want about the church online, Facebook, Instagram, or at our website, Regeneration Church WV, and you know, we love having Alchemy as a part of that, and like, I'm so glad that we were able to support everything that you guys do. So.
Fantastic. Well, being there rehearsing, I've seen so many groups meeting in the church. It's just fantastic seeing a church full of people doing, you know, just all kinds of things. It's just fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, Caden. I really appreciate it. Looks like we're about to head in momentarily.
Thank you.
We're getting close to the premiere movie of the movie. I'm John Campbell, board member with Alchemy Theater Troupe. We're outside the Pullman Marquee Theater. There's the red carpet right behind me, and the premiere of Hay Fever, the movie, is about to start. But with me is a very, very, very important person. Becky McClellan is in charge of costumes and props. Now, I've seen the preview clips. I've seen some of the pictures, and boy, they look fabulous.
Thank you. Honestly, Stephen Vance chose the vast majority. He's the director. He chose the vast majority of the costumes. It was my job to make sure they all fit. They were pressed. They were steamed. They were there. They had all the parts they needed. So as far as costumes go, the selection was very much Stephen. But I had a great time gathering them up, of course, and stitches here and there.
Well, you had to make it work, right?
I had to make it work. Yeah.
He could have a vision and pick it, but you had to make it work. And then the props for this.
Oh, my. So I'm used to doing live theater. And one thing I thought that would be easier about doing the movie is, like, in live theater. So we've got a breakfast scene. So in live theater, I have to fix breakfast every night that we run the show. And then I have to clean it up every night that we run the show. Well, this time, I'm only fixing breakfast once. So, hey, this is easy, right? Except that they started shooting the breakfast scene at about 11 o'clock in the morning. And they finished it at about 20 after 6.
Oh, my.
So every time they ate, I had to reset everything exactly as it was. I had to make sure all the food was exactly as it had been. I had to make sure there was enough to refill everything constantly. And that's just, you know, one of the examples of the differences. It was quite a different experience.
Wow. Well, thank you, Becky. This was filmed at the Coin Harvey House here in Huntington. And we want to thank Mickey St. Clair and the Coin Harvey House, which is being restored by Foundation. Mike, back to you.
All right, we're going to go right over here, Todd. We're going to go over to the red carpet, and we're going to talk to Nora Ankrom once more. All right, we're going to do a little bit of a traveling shot here.
We're missing half the people in the movie that are not here.
What's going on? All right. Okay. As you can see, we have got so many people, so many beautiful people standing here on our red carpet getting pictures. And we're going to talk to Nora Ankrom, and we'll see if we can grab Stephen Vance right before we have to wrap it up and go in and see a movie. Nora? Stephen, can we borrow you for a second?
Absolutely.
All right. Let's step on in here. Come on, Todd.
Look at this pretty light.
Yeah.
Light.
All right. We're going to wrap it up right here on the red carpet. So tonight, premiere of Hay Fever the movie. It's been sort of a labor of love for all of you guys.
Forever.
Stephen, we haven't gotten to talk to you yet. Can you tell us just a little bit about how this production came to be?
I made barbecue and on my back porch, and we're like, we need to do something because we're all going crazy. And we thought, what's the best thing that we can do? Hay Fever been on my list since the beginning because when I first directed, back when, it was the other show that I was considering. I'm glad I waited. It's perfect. Like, I couldn't ask for a better cast, crew, everything we know happened in the right time for the right reason, and there's no doubt about it in my mind at all. Like, just look around. I mean, that's enough to tell me.
Absolutely. So many people here. I think this is fantastic. So let's go ahead and wrap it up. So we'll go back to Nora, Executive Director for Alchemy Theatre, and we're going to talk real quick about where we can see Hay Fever. If you missed out on your tickets, and since you're at home, I guess you did, where can we see Hay Fever in the future?
So we have our second showing at Ritter Park on Friday, the 21st, next Friday at 8 p.m., and we have a third showing at Heritage Station on Wednesday, May 26th at 8 p.m., and both of those tickets are available on the website.
Fantastic. And the second showing, is that part of the Arts Night Out?
It is. It is. Yeah, it'll be on the patio at Heritage Station through Arts Night Out.
That sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun, an outdoor menu, drinks, food, whole nine yards?
Yeah, there'll be lots of other vendors around and lots of stuff to do.
That sounds fantastic. And we've got a couple of things in the works for Alchemy, right?
We do. We do. We have the West Virginia Shakespeare Festival coming up, the fourth annual this year, featuring two plays, the complete works of William Shakespeare, Abridged and Antigone, and a full menu of workshops and speakers with that. We also have Exit Laughing coming in September, directed by Mary Williams, and Cozy Christmas, written by Mike Murdock and Simon Woods, coming this December.
Our very own Mike Murdock and Simon Woods. Now, that one promises to be hilarious. It's going to be a bit of a spoof of all of the Hallmark movies you've ever seen. I cannot wait for that one. Well, folks, I think it's about time. We're going to head in and get things started and watch Hay Fever the movie. Thank you all very much for joining us. Thank you, Nora. And we will see you all next time. Until then, take care.